So you're probably gonna be seeing this for like the next 100 videos. Like seriously, these baby hairs are being ridiculous. Like they won't be tamed. Okay, so I wanted to talk in this video about homeschooling and why we're choosing to do it, and just exactly what's gonna get us started to do it, and what is our plans for the future. So first of all, the reason why we're doing homeschooling is just something we decided to do that I think would really be better for our family. If you guys don't know if you know, but my son Josiah, he tends to get sick a lot, and I was really concerned about him really being around a lot of other sick kids. When he does get sick, then he gets this nasty, like, cough going. We have to use the nebulizer, we're gonna use steroids, we're gonna use all this medication just to get him better, and then by the time he's better, and if he was in school at this time, he would be behind in school, and not being able to catch up with the other kids because he has to take all these days of school off because he's sick. And I know that there's a possibility he will probably be growing out of it in a few years, but if he were to go to school, he'd be going to preschool this next fall, and I'm pretty sure he's not gonna be growing out of it this year because it's still pretty strong. And then every year it's just a battle. Like during the flu season, it gets ridiculous. And I didn't see the point in just putting him into school with a bunch of other sick kids, and then he come home, once a month, and he has to skip a week of school once a month, and just didn't see worth it. Another reason is just something that I don't know. My husband and I have been talking about it. We've been praying about it and seeing if it was right for our family. It just feels right to do. It's something that I think I would really enjoy with doing as a mother, and I think it would be better for Josiah to help him with his learning. He gets very distracted by other children around him when he learns, and I think that if I were to teach him, well, I am teaching him now, just little things here and there, and he just seems to be learning a lot just from the at-home environment. It's not stressful at all for us to do this at home. The only issue we have is just space, and I just need to work on my organization skills. So those are the reasons why we're homeschooling, and our approach to it is that right now, since he's only three, he's turning three in about a week, and on the 17th, so Monday the 17th, be turning three. And for right now, all we're doing is, as you can guys see our little hearts up there, we're learning about hearts this month because it's February, and we're learning the colors like purple and pink, so purple and pink colors basically. And if you guys saw in one of my videos up here in my window, I have a cute little hearts mobile. So we've been working on the shape of hearts and just certain colors like that, and then just visualizing. He can see those things and he goes, "Oh, look," just pointing at it and go, "Yes, Josiah, that is a purple heart, or that is a pink heart, or a red heart." And then just, repeating those things, and then he will repeat them back. "Oh, heart, red heart." And it's just, constantly communicating with him in that way, and it makes the brain click. And then there's also little things too. You can get just Dollar Tree is wonderful place to get things. In my opinion, like, it's either you pay $5, $6 for a poster board that has shapes and colors on it, or you pay $1 that you get two poster boards with shapes and then colors on it. Like, seriously, what's the difference? And Dollar Tree, you can get flashcards, you can get color like puzzles and workbooks, and I'll show you guys what I have here, just what we've been doing a little bit. And right now I actually have over here on this wall, there's like a little shapes poster board. Here, I'll show you guys. It's like a little shapes. And on this side there's colors. You'll have to ignore my mess. It's still organizing. And I mean, he knows most of his colors for the most part. Blue, red, green, purple, yellow. Yellow is his favorite color to say for some reason. And then over here for numbers, because we're not quite onto the letters yet, but I just kind of put numbers out, the numbers 1 through 10. They're the little Mickey Mouse flashcards you can get from Dollar Tree. They come in a package like this, colors and shapes. And I figure I already have a shapes board, and once he gets down the shapes up here, then we can go ahead and take those down, and then we can put these up so that there are different kind of shapes. He can kind of see that shapes don't always look that big or look like that color. Sounds like my husband's home, I don't know. But oh, Like right here, red circle, blue circle, yellow circle, green circle. And then it just keeps going on and on. And then it has other shapes in here too, like brown triangle, yellow triangle. Okay, I'm gonna see if my husband's home really quick. Okay, there's just construction going on next door, so that's why I hear, my husband has a really loud truck, and so I can always hear when he's coming, and it sounds like him, but it's not, it's just construction. And so, yeah, these are just from the Dollar Tree, and we just have numbers up here, just laying out, and Josiah got so excited, he was pointing at them. I said, yeah, that's 1, 2, 3, and then he was saying the numbers not in order, but he was saying them. So there is some kind of connection going on there, if you think about it. I mean, we have to learn somehow, whether it be in order or not. And he actually said 4 and 6 a couple times, just like pointing at 4. Yeah, that is right. That is a 4. And then right below it, there's just like, how many is there? So there's 4, and then there's 4 little objects there. So 1, 2, 3, 4. So counting with him and showing him, oh look, there are 4 objects, 4 items under this number 4. And then you count them with him. It's not really hard to do to teach a preschooler. It really isn't. It's actually been really fun because it just, you could see his eyes light up when he gets it. So this is a suggestion. They have a lot of other things at the Dollar Tree too. This is the numbers and counting. We had the numbers up there already, so I'll go ahead. This is actually kind of a weird one because it only goes up to number 18, which I thought was weird. So they actually have the number, and then they actually have all of the different objects there. So the thing that we have, we'll just go ahead and do 18 and 18. So this is how we have it up on the wall there. So we have the number 18, we have the number of items underneath, so he can count with me and he can say and see what it is. So that's how we have that on the wall. And he just loves to come over and just look at them, and he likes to point things out. Mickey's on a tractor over here, so he goes, oh, tractor. And I tell him, yes, Josiah, there's 5 tractors there, isn't there? And he'll count with me. So flashcards are really awesome. There's also some more flashcards that I got from like our local learning store, and this specific picture words says ages 5 and up, but I don't really look at the ages anymore. I just kind of look what's on the back here. So like on the back it shows all of the different things that are on there. So there's animals, clothing, transportation, common objects, common shapes, colors, safety signs. Obviously, he's not going to know the safety signs, transportation. Some of those might be kind of hard. Animals, he could say a lot of those. Clothing, there's specific ones he has trouble with. Thank you. Just put those right up there. Thanks, buddy. And, I mean, I just kind of picked them out here. And then, I think right here, I just kind of sorted them. So, like right here in this little package, there's colors that I put. And then we just grab one of those out. We just grab one of these out sometimes, and we just kind of do a small little trivia for him. And when we're sitting on the couch, or and he's just reading a book with me, and he'll, you know, I said, Josiah, go get your flashcards. He'll bring the box to me, and we'll work on his little colors and shapes and whatever we have in there, animals. Let's see. Another thing that I found, this was actually at Ross, Dress for Less, and there's a puzzle piece missing. But I brought this home, and white is missing. I think it's just underneath my cabinet over here. What's wrong? What? Use your words. What's wrong? Okay, that's fine. You can leave it out there. You want to play it? Okay, I'm going to show them it. So this is his puzzle, and he puts this together so well, guys, and we just remind him what they are when he puts them down, a black square, yellow star. So, can you point some of those out? What's this? And he can tell you what they are, most of them. The circle, the heart, the star. Here, buddy, you can build it. There you go. He does really well building that. The things that we got from Dollar Tree, this is the only thing Well, actually, there's a few of these things. So this was actually from Walmart. This is something we kind of take on the go. We have a dry erase marker, and it's really great for when we go to the doctor. And this is a little bit advanced for his age, but he just likes to look at the pictures for now, and it is way beyond what he needs to be doing. Yeah, he just likes to look at the pictures, and then he just likes to use his dry erase crayon on them, and I can just erase it when he's done. He likes to just color stuff on there. He can't read the words, but it's just introducing him, and just him seeing these things, like letting him know that, oh, this is a maze, so we gotta find our way from one point to the other, or... you know, he's just looking at the objects, you know, he's just getting to understand. It's like, this is a yellow hat, there's a hammer, and he just gets excited, and he sees that they're daddy's tools on here, so it's something for him to recognize. And even if something is really advanced and above their level, go ahead and grab it anyways. This was on sale, only $1.50 at Walmart, on the clearance rack, and I think what was wrong with it was just out of the packaging or something. Because it was normally like $3.99. Yes, you can have some water. Let me have a drink first. Before you backwash it. So this is really awesome. Yeah, like you don't have to be specific if it says like this says grade K, so for kindergarten. I mean, like this is only one grade, but like higher than what he would be in. He just likes to carry it around. We just like to put little dry erase crayons, and it's just really great to have her on the go. Other things here, this is kind of above his level a little bit, but this is for ages 3, 4, and 5. This was on sale at our local bookstore. It was only like $6 for this book. It was normally like $15. And then actually on the inside of it, like the very first couple pages is lines. And he loves to do them. So I just take these and I just print them off on my computer for now. And he just likes to draw the lines, like from the cat to the cat. Let's draw the pig to the pig. Look at the pink pig. Oh, look at the panda bear. Isn't that a cool panda bear? Let's draw that panda bear to that one. And just, you know, having him look at those little tiny pictures and then drawing the lines. I just dropped all my books. Let's see. He hasn't gotten into these yet because I just got them. This is something, hold on buddy, this is something that my mother got. This was actually from Michael's in the dollar section. It's Sesame Street, he can recognize the characters. Oh, he can see Zoe, look at, what color is Zoe, is she orange? And then, like, look buddy, there's Grover, what color is Grover? Look, is he going to school? Just like, you know, just like showing him, just... him seeing these things is really important. So, that's awesome. And then these are the ones from the Dollar Tree. And these are Learn Colors and Learn Shapes, because these are the two biggest things that we're working on. For right now, we'll be working on these all throughout summer. Not like head on, but for right now, I just kind of have them sit down for a little bit and just kind of look at stuff. And then every night we read and... we always are doing something throughout the day, looking at something. Here. Hey, that's not okay. Here, you can play with this. You can play with these flash carts. Swami doesn't really like these. Here you go. Play with those. Dollar Tree, learn colors, learn shapes. So the colors ones, I actually had a really cool idea. Dollar Tree has these bingo dots, and you don't always have to have your child color with a crayon. Like, let them do different things. So, like, maybe one time a week crayons, and let them do washable markers, let them do paint, let them do stickers. I mean, you don't want them just to always be just pencil in hand. I mean, that's not fun for them. So I got these cool bingo dots. These are really cool, and we're going to be doing this on his favorite color, blue, soon. So, red is first in this one, but we can just skip to blue. So, like here. You can read it. Can you help color Tubby's turtle? Tubby Turtle's umbrella blue? So he can take the little bingo dots and then he can just kind of dot the umbrella blue. And then, I mean, down here they have the word blue, which is just a little bit hard for him to understand, but I can kind of help his hand a little bit and say B-L-U-E, blue. And that's just kind of introducing letters and how to, you know, like, that's what the color blue, that's what it looks like in the letters type of thing. Blue's more than just a color, it's also, that's how you say it and all of that stuff. And then on this side, of course, you can color all the blue balls Yeah, these are really great books. Oh, can you find the blue birds hidden in the tree? And he can circle those. And, like, these are really cool. And the shapes are a little bit harder for him to get because you got to trace them. But who said you got to trace them with a pencil? You can trace them with a marker, or maybe let's do noodles or like gluing or stickers or something. So just like, this is just all that we've been doing. This is all that we're starting out with. Yes. What is this?
Okay.
You gotta put the card in there? You gotta bend these a little bit. Sorry for all the interruptions. Here you go. And that's all that we've been doing. It's just been really easy going, and it's like I don't have to get my child up at 7 o'clock in the morning to get ready for school. We still do activities during the day. We just have a lot of fun with it, and that's what I really encourage as parents with preschoolers, is just have fun with it. And when you're talking to your child, like, oh, look, Josiah, what is this? A pumpkin. So look, this is an orange pumpkin. The pumpkin is round like a circle. And then just using words like that to get him introduced to that stuff. And I have a long ways to go before he actually has to have that engraved in his mind. But I mean, who says you can't start at 3 or 2.5 or whatever? It's just really good for him to be really seeing all of these things, the numbers and the shapes and the colors all over the walls. Just introducing him. That's all that we're doing right now. And it's been a really fun experience. So if you guys have any suggestions or advice, I'd love to hear them. Or anything like that, questions are welcome down below. Thank you guys so much for watching. Bye.